Yes.
When it was there, it's lost 45 miles an hour. That is causing the wind field to get bigger. And the wind field, as it continues to slow down, is going to continue to go ahead and expand because there's not enough centrifugal force in the eye to pull that back in together. So what happens is that centrifugal force is what compresses the size of the hurricane. And as the centrifugal force lessens, as the speed goes down, then the field, the wind field, expands in response to that. Now, here's the problem that you've got. Now, I thought that was a really horrible position that gentleman's in to answer the question, when is this thing going to do what it's going to do? For whatever reason God decided, he stopped that hurricane right over Grand Bahamas. And excuse me for being a God believer, but I am. And what has happened is it's stuck between two competing forces trying to drive it. You have one on the east side of the storm, which is a high-pressure system, that before had been actually pushing it to the west. That collapsed because you can't see it on the map that you've got up there right now. But there is a dip in the jet stream, they're called a trough, that is coming down. It's in Tennessee now. It's going to be in Georgia shortly. It's coming down into that way there. And it caused that high-pressure system to move towards the east, and it stopped steering the hurricane. To the west of the hurricane, on the other side of Florida, you have what is becoming a tropical depression. It should be that's about a 70%, 80% chance of being tropical depression within the next 48 hours. And it is also pushing from the southwest and keeping it there. Now, as the hurricane sits there, it will continue to lose some speed because what happens is the warm, hot waters off of the Gulf Stream that have been feeding this hurricane to get it to pop the way that it did. But as the hurricane sucks at that water, see, a storm surge. Let me explain how a storm surge occurs because there is a vacuum in effect in the eye of the hurricane because its pressure is so much lower than the air pressure all around it. It literally sucks the water up into the eye, maybe 15, 20, 25 feet, whatever it might be. And that is what you're experiencing now in flooding and in this surge, is that because the eye is where it is, it has sucked this water up into it, and it is causing that surge to go across Grand Bahama. And that's what's happening there. So this is caught, and until this trough gets down low enough into Georgia, which is where it's going to have to be, until it gets there, this hurricane is going nowhere. This hurricane is going to sit there. It is not going to go anywhere. Now, the gentleman was interviewed, I believe, on another station, and I won't mention it, of course, but he said he'd never seen anything like this in the Bahamas. That's true. This is a world record. It has never happened before.
It's never happened before.
What you guys are living right now, never, 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 never has the Bahamas ever suffered the way that it's suffering today and will suffer tomorrow. Never once has this ever happened. This is a record-setting hurricane. It is tied for the second most powerful hurricane in the Atlantic Ocean ever since they've been keeping records in 1851. The second highest ever. And then as far as the records go for landfall, it is tied for first. Never before has anybody on Earth seen this occur in the Atlantic Ocean. What you are going through is straight from the gates of hell. There is no other way to explain it. And I apologize, I hope it doesn't offend anybody, but my understanding is the Bahamian people are a highly believing people. Yeah. So I hope that doesn't offend you by any means. But this is straight from the gates of hell. There's just no way around it. And it's going nowhere until that trough gets down there. And when the trough arrives, then it will begin to give it a push over towards Florida. The wind field will have expanded, and then it's going to be West Palm Beach's turn. And then it's going to be Vero Beach's turn. And then it's going to be Cape Canaveral's turn. And there's still a possibility, although it's less than it was, but there's still a possibility that it's only got to move 50 miles to the west, and we will have landfall in Florida. And then we will suffer that. That will occur here. But right now, there's nothing anybody can do. And I want to say this also for the weather forecasters. Why would anybody go into this situation expecting a world record hurricane. You've got to be fair to those guys. Mm-hmm. Go ahead. Now I'm done. I'm done. I've said what I have to say, but please stay where you are. Do not go out. There will not be any breaks in those bands for, I don't feel, at least 18 to 24 hours. But okay, I'm done. I'll take any questions.
Let me ask you, what does this mean for the rest of the Bahamas, particularly the Northwest Bahamas? Will we continue to feel what we're feeling right now, which is rainy weather, overcast, some winds? This is affecting the entire Northwest Bahamas.
Yes, sir. Right, and you can look at the infrared, and you can see that the infrared covers the vast majority of the Bahama Islands in that red area. That's the worst part of the hurricane. And the worst winds are in the blackened part of the red area. That's where you have the coldest cloud tops and the highest gusts.
Wow. Well, I'll tell you, sir, we appreciate you sharing your knowledge with us. And one thing that this storm didn't take into consideration, it came to a nation where people begin to pray and people pray hard.
Yes.
And so if anybody that can move this storm out of the way, it's the Bahamian people.
That's right.
And now that they've heard this, people will trouble the throne room and you will see a miracle. This storm is going to move.
Got to move.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much, sir, for talking to us.
Mm-hmm. And you are so very kind to give me this great privilege. Thank you and God bless
you. Thank you. We appreciate it.